Okay, so the first exercise is called a knee leg press. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna use, it's just a strap. The first thing that we're gonna do with the strap is we are going to put it around your foot and we're gonna use some of the muscles at the front of your leg. So what you're gonna do first is you're gonna slightly bend your knee to probably about a 30 degree angle, about there. Then you're gonna hold on tightly to the strap, and what you're gonna do now is you're gonna push your foot down into the strap and tighten the muscle at the front of your thigh.
And hold really tight.
Hold tightly and push against there. So you're gonna try to straighten your knee. And you're gonna hold it for a count of three, and then you're gonna relax. So now we'll just switch the strap to the other foot. Again, around the ball of your foot. You're gonna hold tightly with both of your hands, slightly bend your knee to about 30 degrees, and then you're gonna push down into the strap and try to straighten your knee. We would ask that you start with doing three repetitions on each leg and work your way up to doing 10 repetitions twice a day. The next exercise that we're gonna do is, again, for the thigh muscle, and what we're gonna use here is a small roll. The cushion should be positioned right behind the crease of your knees. And what I'm gonna ask you to do is I'm gonna ask you to straighten your knee. So we'll start with this leg. You're gonna straighten your knee out and pull your toes up slightly. Hold for a count of three and then relax. And come all the way down, good. And now we'll do it on the right side. Straighten that knee, pull your toe up. Hold one, two, three, and relax. We are gonna start with three repetitions on each leg and work our way towards 10 repetitions twice a day. The next exercise I want to show you is, it's called hip abduction. So what we're gonna do here is we're going to slide your left leg out away from your body, and you're gonna slide it as far as you can comfortably. So you're gonna slide it out until you feel a little bit of a stretch, and then you're gonna hold it for a count of three, and then you're going to use your muscles to pull your leg back towards the center. So we're gonna slide that right heel out towards the side of the bed to the place where you feel like you're comfortable. Hold it for a count of three, and then you're going to pull your foot back in towards the middle. The next exercise we're gonna do is in standing, and what we would recommend that you use is a chair with a back on it that doesn't have wheels, or else use your kitchen counter or your kitchen sink, something that's about waist height so you have something firm to hold on to. So the first exercise we're gonna do is called a standing hamstring curl, and this is for the back of the thigh muscle. So what you're gonna do first is you are going to hold on tightly to the chair for balance, and then you're going to lift your heel towards your bum, bending it to about a 90 degree angle if you can. So go ahead and try that, and once you get to the top, I want you to hold it for a count of three, then slowly lower it to the ground. Then you're going to switch and you're going to go to your other leg. You're going to bend that knee, pull that heel towards your bottom, hold for a count of three, and slowly lower towards the floor. The next exercise that we're going to do is called standing hip abduction. So again, we're going to be taking the leg out to the side. So again, you're using your chair or the kitchen counter, something of that height for balance. And what you're going to do is you're going to lift your left leg slightly outwards to the side, but I want you to think about taking it slightly behind you, not just going straight out to the side. Then you're going to shift your weight onto the left leg, and you're going to raise your right leg out to the side and hold for a count of three and then bring it back. The next exercise that we're going to do is for your calf muscles, and they're called a standing calf raise. So again, you're holding onto your firm surface, and what you're going to do now is you're going to go up onto your toes, raise yourself up onto your toes as high as you feel comfortable, hold for a count of three and lower yourself back down. And this one you're going to be doing both feet at the same time. And down, good. The last exercise that we're going to do is in a chair. And what you're going to do is you're going to slide yourself forward so that you're not firmly planted at the back. You're going to sit sort of towards the edge, maybe a little further back towards the middle of the chair. Yep. And you need to use a chair with armrest because this exercise is designed to help your arms with the same muscles that you use to push yourself up from a seated position. So you're going to have your knees and hips bent at about a 90 degree angle. And then what you're going to do is you're going to push yourself up using your hands, and you're going to straighten up, not quite to a fully straightened elbow, so about halfway between what you are right now and fully straight. So you're going to push yourself up, And you're going to hold one, two, three, and then you're going to slowly lower down.